Another festival. I want to thank you all so much for being here this weekend. I think it's been especially fulfilling, not only with all the tremendous music and musicians we've had a chance to hear, but the reason that we're here, which is to pay tribute to such an incredible, incredible legacy. And I think you can see now through all the different things, all the films, the photographs, and all the music and the different concerts, that things would be much different if it hadn't been for our very special guest and the person that we're here to pay tribute to. And one last time, I want you all to join me for this weekend in thanking Howard Rumsey. So as you know, when Howard wound down his time at the Lighthouse in the early 1970s, without missing a beat, just went down the street a little bit to Redondo Beach and opened Concerts by the Sea. And Concerts by the Sea was a tremendous place that played host to everyone you can think of in the jazz world. And we certainly wanted to close things out at the festival by acknowledging Howard's tremendous club, Concerts by the Sea. And one of the great albums, you know, there are several things done at Concerts by the Sea, but one of the great albums recorded there really helped to introduce the Bob Florence limited edition to the world. It came out on the Trend label. As a matter of fact, the guy that engineered that was doing things for Discovery at the time, is here this weekend, and he's the guy that does our membership CDs, and that's Rod Nickus. Rod's in there, he is. The other reason we wanted to, you know, we hadn't seen John Thomas in a while, and we knew that the sure way to get him here was to do a Bob Florence limited edition concert. And sure enough, John's here. There he is, right there. John is a big fan of this album, and he always would ask Bob to do music from it, so it's going to be quite a treat for all of us. The Bob Florence limited edition that in 1979 performed at Concerts by the Sea, and Rod recorded it for Albert Marks for the Trend label, and we thought it would be an appropriate way to close things out tonight. So would you please welcome our tremendous all-star band playing the music of Bob Florence from Concerts by the Sea. And the director tonight is one of three of the original members that were on that album, and it is Kim Richmond.
Thank you. Several of you know the name of that tune.
Bebop Charlie.
That's right. That man a prize. Charlie was Charlie Niles, Chuck Niles, and he introduced the band on a number of occasions, and he was a real mentor for the Bob Florence limited edition. That's what they called the band after this gig. It was a limited edition by Bob Florence. And you heard one of the original members play his original solo, well, not exactly, Charlie Loper on the trombone. And on tenor saxophone, Tom Peterson. I want to tell you a little bit. We call that a record album cover. And I just wrote down who the originals were on it because I wasn't quite sure because I couldn't remember. But the Trumpets were Buddy Childers, Steve Huffsteter, who's still here. And then Nelson Hatt, Gene Goh, and Warren Looney. Those were the Trumpets. And I must say, this is subjective, but my opinion is that Buddy Childers was one of the best lead trumpet players I've ever played with. It was really sensational. He will appreciate that. The trombones were Charlie Loper, as you see here, Herbie Harper, Don Waltrip, and Chauncey Welsh. The woodwinds were Bob Cooper, Pete Chrislieb, Ray Peasy, Bill Perkins, Lee Callett, and myself, Kim Richmond. The rhythm section was Joel DiBartolo, Nick Ciroli, and of course Bob Florence on the piano. So, I think there's only four of us left. And so that's, with still the music lives though, doesn't it? Don't you think so? Well, Warren Looney was one of the principal soloists of the Bob Florence Band, and he did a lot of studio work. He was busy all the time. In fact, the few television dramas that I did, I hired him as a solo trumpet player. We have one of the wonderful solo trumpet players with us tonight. They're all soloists back there, but this guy is one of my favorites, as you may know, because we've led groups together, and that's Clay Jenkins. We're going to feature him on Lonely Carousel.
Thank you.
Clay Jenkins on cover. Now, when we got that out and I listened to Warren Looning's solo, I said, nobody can play that like Warren Looning, you know, and nobody could. So I didn't ask Clay to do that. I asked him to play it like Clay Jenkins. Clay Jenkins on trumpet. Now, you might have seen this big instrument up here that Bob Carr is playing, and many of you are going to ask me what it is or ask him. And that's a contra alto clarinet. Is that correct?
Yes.
Like a contra clarinet.
Contra alto.
Contra alto. That's right. Contra alto clarinet. Said he'd call it the anti-clarinet. That's lower than the one that Bob Efford has down there, which is the bass clarinet. Okay. You also, besides Clay, you heard Don Shelton on the saxophone right here. I used to be able to play that part, and I just always tried to play it like Don. And it's just a marvelous sound he had. And you heard that on the last set, too. Okay. The next tune is Bob's tribute to his wife, Evie. Unfortunately, Evie couldn't be here tonight, but we have two of Bob's children here, and I want to just introduce them. That's Melanie and Russ. They're sitting right back here somewhere. That's Florence. Thank you for coming. So this next one is called Evie, and these are all originals, by the way. There's no standards in this particular album. So he wrote all originals, and this is the one he wrote for Evie.
Thank you.
That was called Evie. And you heard Alex Budman on the alto saxophone. Another subjective comment. Every time I play next to Alex, I get inspired in some way. He's just a wonderful saxophone player, whether it's on alto, soprano, or tenor. Alex Budman. He's one of the new faces in the last 50 years. We all know about that, right? Okay, and you heard Andy Langham on the piano. Short story. Well, I just want to let you know who you're looking at here and listening to. And, of course, the saxophones. Don Shelton on lead alto there. Alex. Well, let's not applaud till I get the whole section done. They'll want more money. You heard Alex Budman on the alto saxophone. You have Tom Peterson on tenor saxophone. Glen Berger on the tenor. Bob Efford and Bob Carr on the baritone saxophone. Let's hear it for the saxophone. The trumpets back there, Ron King, Jeff Bunnell, they're the two lead players. The soloists are Clay Jenkins, Steve Huffsteter, and Ron Stout, the trumpet section. And by the way, when I say they're the lead players, that doesn't mean they don't play solos very well. They're both excellent soloists, those lead players. And I think that the soloists can play lead sometimes too, although they don't like to. Right, Steve? He's in a fog back there, it's okay. Okay, the trombones are Scott Whitfield, Charlie Loper. I knew I'd forget. Paul Young? Yes, he's one of the newcomers, too. And Craig Gosnell. Sorry, Paul. That's our trombone. Paul Young is so new to me, I had him as a student at USC years and years ago, so I should remember his name. Okay. And we have David Hughes on the bass. You can applaud him. There's another newcomer, really a wonderful bass player, plays with my large ensemble also. And Andy Langham again on piano. So, holding it all together, and he was with the Bob Florence Band for many, many of the last years. That's Dick Weller on the Okay, we're going to go on to the second half of the album. This is the flip side. Remember that? Call it flip side, B side. Okay. And this is a tune that featured Chauncey Welsh on the recording and in live. And he was one of the prime soloists of the band and really wonderful trombone player in the studios and jazz groups and so forth like that, and I was happy to get to know him. We're going to feature Scott Whitfield on this. It's called Wide Open Spaces. Thank you.
Thank you.
He has an uncanny habit of sounding like a trumpet because he plays so damn high. We were playing, as a matter of fact, this was with Bob Florence one time. We used to play in small groups together and took a group up to Mammoth and so forth. It was a quintet. And one time we were playing at, can't remember the name of the club. It was on Ventura Boulevard. Spazio's, I think it was, yeah. And Scott was to play with us. It was going to be like a quintet. And he called a couple, where he said, I just had my wisdom teeth taken out. He says, I don't know if I can make it, you know. So we said, well, when we get right to that day, let me know. You know? So got to that day and I talked to him on the phone. He said, well, I don't know whether I can play or not. I says, I'm going to have to really take it easy. This guy does not take it easy. He played up in the stratosphere, just like he did today, and he's all over the place. I wouldn't have known he'd had anything wrong with him or any operation or anything like that. And I said, Scott, I thought that you were in pain, and I thought you couldn't do this. He says, well, I just play what I hear. Remember that?
Yeah.
So, anyway, how about Dick Weller on the drums on that piece? Okay, we're proceeding to my favorite piece of the album, and I was talking to some of the guys in the band, and talking to Bob Efford, who was on the band forever, except he wasn't on this album, and not quite on the band yet, and he swore he was on this album, because we played it so often, this piece. We played it every concert, every club we've ever done, and it's my favorite, and as a matter of fact, it's a lot of people's favorite, because there was words put to it. Bob asked Scott Whitfield and Ginger Berglin, or a team, if you know, and to put words to it. It's called Our Garden, right? Our Garden. But we call it here, and Bob called it I'll Remember. I'll Remember. And this is the one that featured Pete Chrisley. We're going to have Tom Peterson play it. Thank you. Sounds on the saxophone, again, Don Shelton. You know, Bob and I were the kind of friends that talk over music a lot. And he told me one time, kind of a secret, I guess, I don't know if it's really a secret, but I said, well, how do you think of tunes, you know? And he said, well, every morning I take a walk. And I walk, you know, around the neighborhood. And he said, I start thinking of a tune, you know, at the pace I'm walking, usually, not always, but at the pace I'm walking, often. And when I get back to the house, I take about a half hour walk at least. So when I get back to the house, I've kind of solidified that tune in my head. So I play it on the piano, and I play it for about an hour, you know. And so then I stop playing it, and I practice something else or write something else and so forth. The next day when I take a walk, if I can still have that tune in my head, then it's a good tune. If I can't, I forget about it. So that's how he came up with it. And I'm sure that tune there that we heard, I'll remember, was one of those tunes that he kept in his head a long time. So, isn't that a pretty tune, though? Okay, now not to think that he did all his songs in one tempo that he walked. He didn't do that. Well, maybe so, because this is double time. But he walked real fast for this one. This is the final tune on the album, and it's called Party Hardy. And it's a blues, and he wrote a lot of blues and so forth, and he liked to write riff-type tunes as well. And he kind of took after Duke Ellington with that habit. But this is an original, and it's called Party Hardy. Hope you enjoy it. We're going to feature several of our soloists on this.
Oh,
on Florence Limited Division. Everybody stand up, please. Thank you so much. We'd like to play one more play. Is that okay? Well, we've got to play something that Bob always finished with. And for us that were in the band, it always brought a tear to our eye. And both eyes is kind of bad. So this is Bob's version of Auld Lang Syne. Thank you.